Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel Math School Learn to Succeed. In this channel, I'll be teaching you Karnataka Board Class 10th SLC NCERT Math. In today's video, let us solve the question number 17 and 18 from exercise 1.3, chapter number 1, Arithmetic Progressions. In my previous videos, I've solved the questions from 1 to 16. If you have not watched that video, please find the link in the description box below or click the I button above. So before we begin this video, please like and subscribe to my channel and don't forget to hit the bell button below to get the latest updates of my videos. Now question number 17 from exercise 1.3 says, in a school, students thought of planting trees in and around the school to reduce the air pollution. It was decided that the number of trees that each section of each class will plant will be same as the class in which they are studying. Example, a section of class 1 will plant 1 tree, a section of class 2 will plant 2 trees, and so on till the 12th class. There are 3 sections of each class. How many trees will be planted by the students? So first let us understand the question. Here in a school, the students are planting the trees in order to reduce the air pollution. Okay, it was decided that the number of trees that each section of each class will plant will be same as the class. Okay, so if a student is in class 1, the class 1 student will plant 1 tree, then a class 2 will plant 2 trees, similarly the third class will plant 3 trees, and so on till the 12th class. Now again they are saying there are 3 sections of each class. Okay, in each class, now class 1 has 3 sections, class 2 has 3 sections, similarly this will go on till the class 12th. So we have to find out how many trees will be planted by the student. So let us understand here, the class 1 will have 3 sections, that is A, B and C, and each section will plant one tree. Okay, since they are in class 1. Similarly, class 2 will have 3 sections, that is A, B, C, and each section will plant two plants. Okay, similarly class 3 has 3 sections, where each section will plant three trees equal to its class. Okay, similarly the class 12th also has 3 sections, A, B and C, where each section will plant 12 trees. So we have to find out how many trees are planted by the students from class 1 to class 12 having 3 sections in each class. So let us write down, since there are 3 sections in each class, therefore the number of trees planted by class 1 is equal to 3. Okay, since there are 3 sections, so number of trees planted will be 1 plus 1 equal to 3. Similarly in the class 2, 2 plus 2 plus 2 it is 6. In class 3, 3 plus 3 plus 3 it is 9 trees totally in class 3. Similarly in class 12, 12 plus 12 plus 12 it will be 36 trees will be planted in class 12. So let us write down, similarly in class 2, 6 trees will be planted, and again in class 3, 9 trees will be planted. Similarly in class 12th, 36 trees will be planted. Therefore let us write down the AP. So the AP is, in the first class there are 3 trees which are planted, in the second class totally 6 trees are planted, in third class 9 trees are planted, and so on. In the 12th class there will be 36 trees that will be planted. So since there are 12 classes, so number of classes are 12, so n is equal to 12. Now we have to find the sum of the trees planted by the 12 classes. From the AP we can find the first term, A is equal to 3, and the common difference is equal to 6 minus 3 is equal to 3. Now here we also know the last term, since we found out the number of trees planted by the 12 classes. So the nth term or the last term is equal to 36. If you don't find out the last term also, we can solve the problem by using the formula Sn is equal to n divided by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Only finding the number of trees planted by first three classes is enough. If you want to find out the number of trees planted by 12 class students, then the n term will be known. Then we can use the formula Sn is equal to n divided by 2 into a plus l. If you don't find out this nth term, then we can use this formula and find out the sum. If you have found out the nth term, then you can use this formula. So let us substitute the values and find out the result. So sum of the 12 classes is equal to n is what? 12 divided by 2 into a value is 3 plus l is 36. So 2 1 times, 2 6 are. So 6 into 36 plus 3 is 39. So what is 6 into 39? 9 6 are 54, 6 3 is 18, 18 plus 5 it is 19, 20, 21, 22, 23. So it is 234. Therefore, the number of trees will be planted by the students is equal to 234. That is S12 is 234. Therefore, the number of trees planted by the students is 234. So this is how we solve this problem. The question number 18 from exercise 1.3, chapter number 1, arithmetic progression says a spiral is made up of successive semicircles with centers alternately at A and B, starting with center at A of radii 0.5, 1.0 centimeters, 1.5 centimeters and 2.0 centimeters as shown in figure 1.4. What is the total length of such a spiral made up of 13 consecutive semicircles? And they also have given the hint, length of successive semicircles is L1, L2, L3, L4 and so on with centers AB respectively. So first of all, let us understand the question here. They are saying as a spiral is made up of successive semicircles. Okay, this is a spiral. If you see in the figure here, this is a spiral made up of successive semicircles. Okay, if you notice, this is one semicircle, then another semicircle is here and another semicircle, four semicircles given here in the figure. So a spiral is made up of successive such semicircles with centers alternatively A and B. For this first semicircle, if you notice, this is the first semicircle with radii A, and the second semicircle is from here to here. This is the second semicircle with radii B, and the third semicircle is this one, L3, with the center A, and the fourth semicircle is this one, the larger one, that is L4, with the center as B. So the center is alternating between A and B. Okay, and the radius of this first semicircle is 0.5, second semicircle it is 1.0 centimeter, and third it is 1.5, and fourth is 2.0 centimeters. Okay, this is shown in this figure. So what is the total length of such a spiral made up of 13 consecutive semicircles? In the figure they have shown only four semicircles, right? But here we have to calculate the length. The length means the length of this spiral we have to calculate made up of 13 such consecutive semicircles. Only four semicircles are shown here in the figure, but we have to calculate for 13 such semicircles. Okay, they have mentioned that the length of the successive semicircles is L1, L2, L3 and L4, the centers AB, that is alternating between A and B respectively. So first of all, let us know how to calculate the length of a circle. Okay, if you have a circle, the length or the perimeter of a circle is given by, that is the perimeter. The perimeter of a circle is nothing but 2 pi r. Since here we are taking semicircle into consideration, okay, we are taking the semicircles into consideration, then the perimeter will be half of 2 pi r. 2 pi r divided by 2, the 2 and 2 will get cancelled. Therefore, the perimeter of a semicircle will be, perimeter of a semicircle is pi r. Okay, this you have to make a note of first initially. So now if we consider the first semicircle, that is L1, okay, this is L1 with center as A, and the radius of this semicircle is how much? 0.5 centimeters. So let us write down length of the first semicircle, that is L1, is equal to pi into radius is R1. Let us take this radius as R1 for the first semicircle. So this will be pi R1. Okay. So what is R1 value? Radius of the first semicircle is 0.5. So this will be pi into 0.5. Now similarly, semicircle that is L2, if you take its center is B, this is the second semicircle, and the radius of this semicircle is 1.0 centimeter, that is R2. Write down the length of second semicircle, that is L2, is equal to pi R2, where R2 is nothing but 1. So pi into 1 is nothing but 1. Similarly, the length of third semicircle, so this is the semicircle that is the with the center A, this is L3, and the radius of this semicircle is again 1.5 centimeters, equal to radius R3. So what is pi into R3? So R3 is 1.5, so this will be pi into 1.5. Now similarly, the fourth semicircle, that is the L4, this is the fourth semicircle with the center B, this is the L4 with radius R4 is equal to 2 centimeters. Okay, so let us write down length of the fourth semicircle, L4, is equal to pi into R4, where R4 is 2. So pi into 2, you get here. Therefore, these are the four semicircles which I was mentioned in the figure. So we are taking the four semicircle. So likewise, we have to find out the length up to 13th semicircle. Okay, therefore, let us write down the AP now. So the AP is, the first semicircle is 0.5 pi. For second, it is pi. Third, it is 1.5 pi. And the fourth, it is 2 pi. And this continues. And we have to find the length of the perimeter for the 13 semicircles or 13 terms. Okay. The last term is not given. The number of terms is given here. We have to find the sum length of sum for such 13 semicircles. Okay. So let us use the sum formula. Sn is equal to n divided by 2 into 2a plus n minus 1 into d. Since we have to find out the sum for the 13 such semicircles or 13 terms, our n value will be equal to 13. A value will be equal to the first term, that is 0.5 pi, and d will be a2 minus a1. What is a2? a2 is pi minus 0.5 pi. Pi is nothing but 1 pi minus 0.5 pi. What is 1 minus 0.5? It is nothing but 0.5 pi only. So d value is this. So let us substitute in the formula and find out the result. So sum for the 13 semicircles is equal to 13 divided by 2 into 2 into a value is 0.5 pi, plus n is again 13 minus 1 into d is 0.5 pi. So this will be 13 divided by 2 into, what is 2 into 0.5? So what is 2 into 0.5? So 5 twos are 10. Okay, 0 into anything is again 0. So since decimal point is there after the one digit, so we are adding the decimal after 0. So this will be 1 again. So 2 into 0.5 is 1 pi, plus 13 minus 1 is 12, again into 0.5 pi. So let us calculate what is 12 into 0.5 pi. So 12 into 0.5 is again 5 twos are 10, carry 1, 5 ones are 5, plus 1 is 60. So 0 into anything is again 0. So after one digit, we are adding the decimal point here. So this will be 6. So 12 into 0.5 is 6 pi. Okay, so this will be 13 divided by 2, 1 pi plus 6 pi, or this will be 13 divided by 2 into 1 plus 6 is 7 pi. Here, if you notice in the brackets, they have given us the pi value that is equal to 22 divided by 7. So let us substitute the pi value. This will be 13 divided by 2 into 7 into pi is 22 divided by 7. So 7 and 7 gets cancelled. This is 2 1 times, 2 1 times, and 1 time. So 13 into 11. What is 13 into 11? 1 3 is a 3, 1 1 is a 1. Into 1 3 is a 3, 1 1 is a 1. So 3, 3 plus 1 it is 4, and this is 1. So this is 143. Therefore, the sum of 13 semicircles, or the length of the 13 semicircles, consecutive semicircles, is 143 centimeters. This is the result. So let us write down. Therefore, the total length of such spiral made up of 13 consecutive semicircles. The total length 13 consecutive semicircles is 143 centimeters. Okay, so this is how we solve this problem. If you have any doubts, please comment me below in the comment section. In my next video, I'll be solving question number 19 from exercise 1.3, chapter number 1, arithmetic progressions. So till then, please like my video and subscribe to my channel. Thank you.